In case a repeated measures one-way ANOVA in SPSS shows a sufficiently low p-value, it is of interest to the researcher between which of the measurements, differences, in regard to the dependent variable can be observed. To achieve this, pairwise comparisons are being done. Those are simply multiple paired t-tests. Thankfully, you don't have to do them manually, at least not yet. The repeated measures ANOVA allows you to request estimated marginal means, which are essentially post-hoc tests. The button post-hoc will work only if you have a between subject effect you want to further investigate, usually in a mixed ANOVA setting. The EM means button is for within subject effects, which is what we are investigating with the repeated measures ANOVA. So click the EM means button and drag your within subject factor into the box display means for. Check compare main effects, and then for confidence interval adjustment select Bonferroni. This is correcting for alpha error inflation, aka a higher chance of committing a type 1 error when testing the same groups multiple times. The p-values will be multiplied with the number of pairwise tests you are conducting to counter the increased chance for a type 1 error. There's not much choice when it comes to other corrections though. You can do other alpha error adjustments by hand only or use R all the way. I simply stick to Bonferroni. Eventually we get a table with all pairwise comparisons when scrolling down quite a bit. In the significance column, the respective adjusted p-values are shown. The mean difference in the first column shows significance indicators on the 5% alpha level. In my example, I can observe a difference between T1 and T2 as well as T1 and T3. This indicates a working intervention, in my case, an exercise plan. Looking at the estimates above, you can also see no further increase or an immediate bounce back since T2 and T3 show no large enough difference worth mentioning. Please consult the paper, the ASA statement on p-values, and draw your own conclusions, dichotomizing decisions based solely on the p-value compared to the alpha level. Finally, you might have observed an effect within your repeated measures one-way ANOVA and no low enough p-values in post-hoc testing when controlling for alpha error inflation. That is not a contradiction, and the internet is full of discussions about this phenomenon of significant tests and non-significant post-hoc tests. Just keep in mind that a p-value, to which it all boils down to, is a function of sample size, which decreases with an increase in sample size for any effect size that is different from zero. So a non-significant test result in almost all cases tells you you're lacking statistical power as a result of too small of a sample. Don't, however, do post-hoc power analysis to justify your non-findings, because the observed power is a one-to-one function of the p-value. After doing post-hoc tests, you should calculate the effect sizes for observed differences, which is shown in the following video.